We're here at GP St. Pete, and we have some interviews lined up for you guys, and it feels so great to be back inside the track. I love it here, and I will see you guys later while we get on with this. Woo-hoo! After 2 years in IndyCar, and as someone always trying to make themselves better, what are things you're still learning in the car to this day?
Well, let me see the answers real quick. No, I mean, I'm still learning a lot, especially around this place. You know, it's been a year and a half since we've been here. I'm still learning about the car. The aero screen's still new. The changes that we're making are different every day. Learning a lot this year with Jimmy Vassar on the stand as my, I'd say, calling the race. It's basically my chief and my boss, so it's kind of fun. But every day presents a new challenge. I mean, look at today. Practice literally for us was up and down and up and down, and now we're just trying to find some consistency.
What's been the biggest challenge for you personally since coming over to IndyCar? What was the hardest part to adapt to for you as a rookie in this ultra-competitive series?
Stepping into the IndyCar series is tough because it's super tight. It's super close. The whole field's within a second of each other. And, you know, every little part on the track that you do in driving counts, everything that you do in engineering counts. And also the cars, the races are a lot longer than what I was used to when I first started in IndyCar. I was used to sprint races. Here it's 3 pit stops. So it's a little different. It's a little different physically, much more challenging mentally. You have the Indianapolis 500, which is feels like forever in the race car because you're on edge for so long. But it's just about endurance coming here, and learning that was definitely not an easy task.
After racing in Europe as a teenager, and then coming into IndyCar and having a successful rookie season with a smaller team, did you ever feel like you need to prove yourself to anyone?
No. I think the team trusted me. The team trusted me with the equipment. The sponsors of the team trusted me to drive the car. It was more not to prove anything to much more anybody else but myself, and I think Dale always had a lot of faith in me and Jimmy Vassar and Sully, so it was one of those things where, especially coming into this year, it was more of just keep working on yourself and just keep improving your results.
Do you feel like you accomplished all of your early goals outside of winning?
Yeah, I'd say I think we had a lot to showcase. I think we did a lot in our rookie year. In our sophomore year, we followed everything up with better results. Obviously, we've been a little bit more unlucky with specific things coming in our sophomore year, but we won't talk about that. And you know, it's been a great showcase, and you know, I'm happy to say I think I've really made a name in IndyCar as a young rookie, and I'm looking forward to a long career here.
Regardless of where you race in the coming years, do you have a desire to try other forms of motorsports? How do you feel about your career trajectory and where you're headed in the future?
I think I'm going to stay in IndyCar for a long time. I really like it here. I would like to try a couple other things. I've got a couple races on my bucket list. The Daytona 24 Hours one, the Charlotte Roval is another. I'd definitely love to get into more dirt racing as I did earlier this year before COVID. So I think there's a lot of things that I'd still want to do, but I'd like to see my main job stay here in the IndyCar paddock.
You took some heat from fans online after the Indy 500 iRacing Challenge. Think of you participating in any official off-season IndyCar iRacing League again, or do you plan to just relax? What's your 2020 off-season going to look like?
I mean, if they start playing Call of Duty, I'm down. But, no, I mean, I did a lot of work with iRacing throughout COVID. I ran a lot of different series for them. I ran IROC. I did a lot of NASCAR stuff. IndyCar is a part of it. I made a mistake, 100%. I was trying to replicate something I literally lost a race to earlier in the week in a super late model. It was not an IndyCar. It was a big mistake on my part, and it looked really bad, and I get that. But no, I wouldn't be opposed to doing some more. You know, I think I'm decent on the simulator. I'm not as good as others, but I enjoy it.
Well, that says it all starts here, but actually all ends here, and so does my video. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know I had tons of fun. I mean, the interviews, everybody here, the energy, it was amazing. And I hope you guys enjoyed it too. So I will see you guys in the next one. Make sure you smash the subscribe button, like, and share, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Later, bye!